Good evening. My name is Keith Badia. I'm president of the Sherryland ISD Board of Trustees. This regular board meeting is being conducted pursuant to Governor Greg Abbott's suspension of certain open meeting law requirements to the extent necessary to allow for telephonic and video conference meetings in response to COVID-19. Notice of this meeting has been posted online for at least 72 hours. The board is meeting by the use of Google Meets and telephones transmission, which allows two-way communication for members of the public during public comments. The live audio of this meeting is being broadcast online. A recording of this meeting is being made and will be available to the public at a later date. The time is now 6:01 p.m. and I'll call this meeting to order. I will now begin the roll call. Melissa Smith?
Here.
Ricky Longoria?
Here.
Pepe Garcia? Dr. Noy Oliveira?
Here.
Hector Rivera?
Present.
Alejandro Rodriguez?
Present.
And the minutes shall reflect that I'm also present and that the record show that a quorum of board members are in attendance. We will now move to item number 3, the invocation, if you'll please rise.
Hi, my name is Emmy Esqueda. I am in third grade and I am from JHS. And please place your right hand over your heart.
Please pause for 1 second, Mrs. Esqueda. Give us 1 second.
If we can all bow our heads. Almighty God, we come together for the good of the children in our schools. Give us your wisdom as we make decisions that will affect them today and in the years to come. Help us to work well together, recognizing that each of us, students, parents, educators, and community members are here because we love children and we certainly want what is best for them. We ask for your blessing and your guidance. In your name, we pray. Amen.
Go ahead, Mrs. Esqueda.
And now the Pledge of Allegiance will be led by Ms. Emmy Esqueda, a student at Sherry Elementary.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now for the Texas flag. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to the Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible.
Thank you very much. Thank you. We'll now move to item 5, recognitions. A, Sherryland ISD Education Foundation Teacher of the Year, presenter Mrs. Klein and Ms. Samaniego.
Are you on camera?
Hi. Hi, Sarah.
Hello. My name is Sarah Samaniego, and I am a board member for the Sherryland ISD Education Foundation. We are a district-wide organization that provides funds for teacher grants. We do scholarships for our teachers to continue their education. We also provide scholarships for our graduating seniors, and we organize community events, all for the sake of our district. I have served on the Teacher of the Year committee many, many years, and it is one of my all-time favorite committees to be a part of. So we're gonna go ahead and get started with that. So the process begins at the campus level, and for the teachers, well, the teachers know how the process goes, but for the parents at home and here, it starts with their peers nominating them for the Teacher of the Year. They have an up-close window to how our teachers function every day because they're side by side. And these are the people that are nominating our teachers at this level. It continues on through the next level is our district teacher of the year, and they select one person from our secondary and one from our elementary. And in that particular process, we do have a independent group, a committee, that reviews those to pass this on to the next level, the region one, state level, and then the national level. So that's how that works. The program criteria is teachers are expected to inspire students of all backgrounds and abilities to learn, have the respect and admiration of students, parents, and colleagues, play an active and useful role in the community as well as in the school. They need to be poised, articulate, and possess the energy to withstand a busy schedule. The Sherryland Education Foundation is directly involved with this award process. We do provide the awards and the checks that we give out to the teachers. We give each teacher from every campus a check and an award. We also do an additional check and award for our two district teachers. All right, so we'll get on to announcing our Secondary Teachers of the Year. We have Baby Ann Sandoval from Sherryland High School. We have Monica Campbell from Sherryland Pioneer High School. We have Deanna Trevino for Sherryland Advanced Academic Academy. We have Raynal Alanis from Sherryland Alternative Education Center. We have Brooke Callanan from BL Gray Junior High. Kaylee May from Sherryland North Junior High. Now on to our Elementary Teachers of the Year for the 21-2022 school year. We have Judy Villarreal from Martinez Elementary. We have Maria Morado from Benson Elementary. We have Stephanie Sines from Hinojosa Elementary. Monica Salinas from Shimatsu Elementary. Veronica Ramirez from Ogarza Elementary. We have Erica Banda from Wernicke Elementary. Next, we have Leticia Arriaga from John H. Sherry Elementary. We have Joanne Larson from Jensen Elementary. I would like to congratulate the Teachers of the Year, and I also do have the wonderful honor of getting to announce today for the first time publicly our two District Teachers of the Year. Our Elementary District Teacher of the Year is Erica Banda from Wernicke Elementary. And next, our Secondary District Teacher of the Year is Barbie Ann Sandoval from Sherryland High School. The Education Foundation, we normally do a banquet at the end of the year for our Teachers of the Year and our retirees that are coming up. Since we aren't allowed to do that, we will be hosting a prize patrol. We will be coming out to the campus, every single campus, and presenting our teachers with their awards, their checks, and they will also be receiving a yard sign so that they can display to all of their neighbors what a great job they do for our district. And, you know, again, I would like to say thank you to the teachers. We do have our Teachers of the Year, but our district is very special, very unique in that we have some of the best teachers in the valley. We are very, very blessed. Our district has done a great job getting us ready for this at-home learning, and our teachers have really risen to the occasion. So I just want to tell all the teachers out there, as a parent, it has been an honor to have my children in your classrooms.
The Education Foundation does a great job throughout the year. We want to thank everybody involved, and thank you, Sarah, for being here representing them. 5B, recognition of the Sherryland ISD employee retirees for the 2020-2021 school year. Presenter, Mrs. Garza.
Good evening, members of the board, Dr. Vidaudi, Mr. Padilla. Tonight, I have the privilege of recognizing our Sherryland ISD staff members that will be retiring during the 2020-2021 school year. We would like to thank them for all their years of service. In total, between all our retirees, they gave over 747 years of service in education. So as with the teachers of the year, we do have a presentation for each one of them that are retiring this year. We're going to start with Santos Aguirre, Sherryland Pioneer High School Maintenance Department, 7 total years of education, 7 years with the district. Rosa M. Avalos, Hinojosa Elementary, Child Nutrition Program Cashier, 29 total years in education, and all of them with Sherryland ISD. Alma G. Barrera, Sherryland North Junior High teacher, 35 years total in education, and 7 years with SISD. Barton B. Bickerton, Sherryland High School teacher, 28 total years in education, and 25 years with the district. Maribel Cantu, Shimatsu Elementary Secretary, 30 total years in education, total years with Sherryland ISD, 30 years. David Cheatham with Garza and Sherry Elementary, music teacher, 36 years in education, 23 years with Sherryland ISD. Esther Cisneros, BL Gray Junior High, custodian, 16 years total in education, with 16 years all being with Sherryland ISD. Belinda Klausner Martinez Elementary, teacher, 15 years total in education, 14 years with Sherryland ISD. Kathleen Corbin, Shimatsu Elementary, teacher, 29 total years in education, 21 years with Sherryland ISD. Amanda Corona de Hernandez, Transportation Department bus driver, 11 years with in education, 3 years with Sherryland ISD. Alejandro Flores, Transportation Department bus driver, 14 total years in education, all of them being with Sherryland ISD. Gloria Galindo, Garza Elementary, Child Nutrition Program Manager, 25 years total in education, 25 years with Sherryland ISD. Maria G. Garza, Special Education Department, Educational Diagnostician, 30 years total in education, 3 years with Sherryland ISD. Sophia Gilliland, Sherryland North Junior High teacher, 30 years total in education, 17 years with Sherryland ISD. Eduardo T. Gonzalez, Sherry Elementary counselor, 30 years in education, 27 with the district. Cami S. Greenman, Sherryland North Junior High teacher, 24 years total in education, 9 years with Sherryland ISD. Carolyn D. Heath, Sherryland North Junior High teacher, 29 years total in education, 9 years with Sherryland ISD. Reveriano Hernandez, Special Education Department teacher, 31 years in education, 26 years with the district. Thelma L. Longoria, Benson Elementary teacher, 29 total years in education, 15 years with the district. Maria Fernanda Maruquin, Central Administration Custodian, 20 total years in education, all of them with Sherryland ISD. Diana Martinez, Sherryland High School, Child Nutrition Program Cashier, 26 total years in education, 26 years with Sherryland ISD. Nidia M. Martinez, Special Education Department, Occupational Therapist, 18 total years in education, all of them with Sherryland ISD. Leonor Montalvo del Cantu, Sherryland High School, Child Nutrition Program, 18 total years in education, 18 total years with the district. Anna L. Ocon, Jensen Elementary, teacher, 29 total years in education, 26 years with Sherryland ISD. Laura Rodriguez, Jensen Elementary, teacher, 32 total years in education, 22 years with Sherryland ISD. Catalina Sarmiento, Sherryland North Junior High, Child Nutrition Program, 7 total years in education, 7 years with Sherryland ISD. Maria O. Sawyer, Jensen Elementary, Instructional Aid, 13 total years in education, 13 years with Sherryland ISD. Maria E. Squibb, Sherryland High School teacher, 16 total years in education, all of them with Sherryland ISD. Phyllis M. Teplicek, Wernicke Elementary teacher, 26 total years in education, 19 years with Sherryland ISD. Richard Thompson, Central Administration Athletic Director, 41 total years in education, 41 years with Sherryland ISD. Hilda A. Zamarron, BL Grade Junior High, Instructional Aid, 23 years in education, 23 years with Sherryland ISD. In May, we will be visiting each one of the campuses to present to each one of our retirees their award and a gift from the district. So thank you, for listening tonight. Thank you.
Yes, I'd just like to say, Mr. Padilla, members of the board, again, for the Teacher of the Year and for the retirees, it's such an unusual year that we can't really celebrate like we'd like to, but definitely want to thank our Teacher of the Years for their nomination and everything that they do for the students. Thank our foundation for everything that you all have done to continue that program and to make sure that our teachers are awarded the best way possible that we can at this time. And also to our retirees, what an honor it's been, at least for your leader for the last 3 years and to have worked with such an incredible group. Thank you for your years of service to the district. So I know I speak on behalf of the board, but thank you so much for that service that you have provided Sherryland ISD.
Thank you.
Thank you. Kind of feels like the Oscars, right? Kind of quiet.
No. Aww. All right, we'll move to 5C. School Nurse Proclamation, presenter Dr. Gorena.
Good evening, President Padilla, Dr. Vidaudi, members of the board. Gives me what an honor to be able to present this piece right here. If you'll quickly glance to the audience, you can see a sea of gray out there. Ladies, wave so they can know where you're at. So our school nurses, our school services, health services team, we know that, as Dr. Vidaudi just mentioned, an unusual year, right? And these ladies have really risen. This year has demanded just, you know, a lot of hard work, a lot of long hours, and they have certainly risen to the occasion. So with that, President Padilla, I just respectfully request that you, if you can read the proclamation for May 2021 to be School Nurse Month.
Okay, proclamation, School Nurse Month, May 2021. Whereas students are the future, and by investing in them today, we are ensuring our world for tomorrow. And whereas families deserve to feel confident that their children will be cared for when they are at school. And whereas all students have a right to have their physical and mental health needs safely met while in the school setting. And whereas the COVID-19 pandemic has emphasized the essential role school nurses play in student health and academic success. And whereas school nurses have served a critical role in improving public health and in ensuring students' academic success since 1902. And whereas school nurses act as a liaison to the school community, families, and healthcare providers on behalf of children's health by promoting wellness and improving health outcomes for our nation's children. And whereas school nurses support the health and educational success of children and youth by providing access to care when children's cognitive development is at its peak. And whereas school nurses are members of school-based teams that address the school population. And whereas school nurses understand the link between health and learning and are in a position to make a positive difference for children every day, therefore be it resolved that the Board of Education of Sheridan ISD does hereby proclaim May 2021 as School Nurses Month in all public schools. We celebrate and acknowledge the accomplishments of Sheridan ISD school nurses. We offer our gratitude for their contributions to our local community during COVID-19 and for helping students stay healthy and ready to learn. Thank you. If you don't mind standing, I want to commend you guys on tackling this year and not hesitating and doing everything that you've been asked and just jumping to the front lines. And I know I'm speaking for myself and for the board that I'm very proud of you guys and proud that you're a part of our team here at Sheridan ISD. So if you'll please stand and we'll give you one more round of applause. Thank you, Dr. Godena.
Thank you.
Item D, Upstart Innovative Programming Award, presenter Christopher Fernandez.
Good evening, board members, Mr. Padilla, Dr. Vidaudi, Sheridan ISD community. It is my privilege to present to you today a wonderful opportunity to acknowledge our district librarian, Ms. Nicole Cruz. She had an upstart presentation and an acknowledgement for a wonderful accomplishment that allowed for us to receive statewide recognition. This is something that in her own innovative way, she was able to generate and create. And I'm very privileged to have the opportunity to present that and to share that with you.
Thank you, Mr. Fernandez. Item E, Vivian Greenfield Scholarship Award to B.L. Gray Librarian, presenter Nicole Cruz.
Proceed, Ms. Cruz.
Oh, hello. I'm so sorry. I think I got disconnected. I am so sorry, board members. May I speak one more time?
Absolutely.
Hate to interrupt.
Yes,
I just
absolutely.
Wanted to acknowledge the full, yes, give her full praise and award. I apologize. The
Good
Upstart
evening.
Innovative
Go ahead, Mr.
Award
Fernandez.
Recognizes two libraries out of the state, and the goal of this award was for good ideas and innovative programs to become visible.
Good
Hello? And I'm therefore,
I got disconnected. I'm so sorry, board members. May I speak one more time? Hate to interrupt.
Yes, absolutely.
Technical difficulties.
I had to mute one person, but Mr. Fernandez, are you still there?
Yes, I am. Am I audible?
Yes.
Hello. This program that Mrs. Nicole Cruz created is an impressive level of engagement between the current high school students and their recent graduates. And I feel that this deserves recognition because our current students will understand what it is to uphold the success of excellence as our tradition. And it gives our entire school, our community, a sense of accomplishment to see not only the graduates excelling at the next level, but to be promoting our future graduates as well. Mrs. Cruz and her wonderful library received a $1,000 check as well as a plaque for this Upstart Innovative Program Award that was recognized for her innovative achievement in creating new programs that help innovate library usage. Thank you, Mrs. Nicole Cruz. Thank you, board members, Dr. Vidaudi, and to the Sherry Land community for your time.
Thank you. And thank you, Ms. Cruz, for all that you do here at Sherry Land. Now we'll move to item E, Vivian Greenfield Scholarship awarded to B.L. Gray Librarian. Presenter, Mrs. Cruz.
Proceed, Ms. Cruz.
And thank you, Ms. Cruz, for all that you do here at Sherry Land. Now we'll move to item E, Vivian Greenfield Scholarship.
Good evening, President Padilla, board members, Dr. Vidaudi, and Sherry Land ISD community. It is with great honor that I am going to recognize a fellow librarian for a scholarship that she received. It's called the Vivian Greenfield Scholarship. And this scholarship was awarded this year to Wendy Prey. She is a librarian at B.L. Gray Junior High. She received a $1,500 check for her ambassador program. The scholarship supports educational endeavors, reinforcing working with youth. And Mrs. Prey's Library Ambassador Program is founded on customer service principles and establishes essential skills for the workforce while supporting the library program. She's looking forward to celebrating their accomplishments by passing on great reads like Tuesdays with Maury, An Old Man, A Young Man, and Life's Great Lesson by Mitch Albom, and For Everyone by Jason Reynolds. Recently, Mrs. Prey was asked to share her ambassador program at the Texas Library Association Conference, which was held this past weekend, and she presented along with two other state librarians from Northwest ISD.
Awesome. I'll go ahead and share the slides. Just run through them really quick.
Once again, a great round of applause for Mrs. Wendy Prey, the B.L. Gray Librarian and recipient of the Vivian Greenfield Scholarship.
Okay, we'll move to item F, Texas Youth Creators Award. Presenter, Ms. Cruz.
Next, it's my great honor to acknowledge students who have won at the state level. And we do this by sharing our Texas Youth Creator Awards. This was founded in 1988, and the purpose of the awards is to promote excellence in amateur media production and share the importance of lifelong learning. This is a statewide event open to school-aged Texas residents. And this year, Sherry Land ISD had six schools with winning entries, students placed at the state level. And I can tell you that at the state level, there were 412 entries. And out of those 412 entries, there were only 118 winners selected. And I'm very proud to say that Sherry Land ISD had 19 state finalists this year. And I wanna congratulate all the students from Ogars Elementary, Shimatsu Elementary, Uriel Gray Junior High School, Sherry Land Advanced Academic Academy, and Sherry Land High School.
Did you want to cover those, Ms. Cruz? Individually?
Just. You can see on the screen, there's a slideshow of all of those different students and their awards. We have student first grade from O'Garza with two different awards. Then we had our Shimatsu Elementary students and also B.L. Gray. I believe that's a video. Both of those were videos that you can see the students' projects. And then Sherrilyn Advanced Academic Academy. You can see on the screen, there's a slideshow of all of those different students and their awards. We have student first grade from O'Garza with two different awards. Then we had.
It's apparently she's streaming it in the background, and we need for her to turn the volume down on that stream to continue. Can you hear us, Ms. Cruz? I believe she's going off the delayed stream, so it's causing a little bit of an issue.
Okay.
That's okay.
We'll bear with it.
No problem.
Great seeing all these talented kids.
I know.
I'm going to go through the slides regardless.
Do you know if she'll be reading off the names, David?
I don't. Every time I speak to her, she doesn't hear me. I don't think she's listening off the stream, so it's delayed.
Oh, I see.
And Ms. Cruz, if you can hear me on the delayed stream, if you want to just start reading through them and I can catch up or go backwards to catch up to you.
Thank you to all the students and librarians who participated in this year's Texas Youth Creators Awards. Very proud of all the work, students. I also wanted to mention that we did get word that one of our students did receive the Bob Bennett Best of Show, and that student is from B.L. Gray Junior High, John Paul Clavio, and he had a graphic design titled MLK. So the Bob Bennett Best of Show is out of all those 118 students, they choose one student that has the best work. And in the past years, we've had a student from Sherrilyn High School and also a student from Pioneer High School. So that is quite an accomplishment. Congratulations to John Paul.
That's great. Okay. Thank you very much, Ms. Cruz. We'll now move to item G, Capturing Kids' Hearts, National Showcase School. Presenter, Ms. Gonzalez.
Good evening, President Padilla, members of the board, Dr. Vidaudi. The Capturing Kids' Hearts program has been implemented with fidelity at Benson Elementary for the last 3 years. The program is based on the foundation that if you were able to capture a kid's heart, we're able to also reach their mind. Every year, Capturing Kids' Hearts spotlights campuses that go above and beyond to build safe and welcoming environments where students are relationally connected and eager to learn. For the second year in a row, Benson Elementary has been selected and named as a national showcase campus for Capturing Kids' Hearts. This journey has become to become a national showcase school has helped build a culture at Benson Elementary that is relationship-driven and tends to the social, emotional needs of the students. Only 325 schools nationwide were named showcase campuses, and Benson Elementary, the only school in South Texas with this recognition. So it is with great honor that we recognize Ms. Susie Garza and all Benson Elementary staff and students for this well-deserved award. So we have Ms. Susie and Ellie here tonight. Thank you.
That's awesome. I remember when they came to present the what Capturing Kids' Hearts were. I think we were in a little office space in the auxiliary building, and I just loved it. I know I can speak for the board, and everybody just loved it, and I appreciate you guys are continuing to grow with this and continuing to be leaders, not only for Sherryland, but for the nation. So thank you very much. We will now move to H, BL Gray Junior High All-Region Band and All-Region Jazz members. Are you two of the jazz, All-Region Jazz members?
Just me.
Ms. Carranza and Ms. Quick.
No.
Yay!
On January 30th, the BL Gray Junior High band members participated in the middle school All-Region Band auditions. Of all the members that participated, we got 38 chairs in this year's All-Region Band. With the unusual circumstances, with the cooperative teaching of Ms. Monica Bloom and Mr. Aaron Vaughn and our high school staff, 38 members got chairs. That's the largest number of students in the 12-year BL Gray Band history and the second in the region. And we are very, very, very proud of our fine young musicians. Diane King, second chair flute. Itzel Garcia, eighth chair flute. Christina Rios, 13th chair flute. Natalie Casanova, 26th chair flute. On oboe, Andrew Herrera, second chair. Hector Ibarra, first chair bass clarinet. Ella Gonzalez, 12th chair clarinet. Sarah Guidez, 17th chair clarinet. Aaron Lee, 22nd chair clarinet. Franco Ortega, 28th chair clarinet. Jaden Mendez, 6th chair alto saxophone. Abraham Barrera, 7th chair alto saxophone. Christopher Tudor, 8th chair alto saxophone. And Draco Santa Ana, 11th chair alto saxophone. Michael Arriaga, Daniel Cantu, 16th chair trumpet. Michael Arriaga, 17th chair trumpet. Jack Fernandez, 20th chair trumpet. And Matthew Blair, 22nd chair trumpet. Madison Hernandez, 4th chair French horn. C.J. Hinojosa, 8th chair French horn. Gael Heredia, 15th chair French horn. And Katia Martinez, 18th chair French horn. I'm really proud of these guys. All these guys were mine. Antonio Reynosa, 1st chair trombone. Angel Cifuentes, 6th chair trombone. Diego Cantu, 8th chair trombone. David Cantu, 10th chair trombone. Jesus Jinez, 13th chair trombone. Kaya Salinas, 14th chair trombone. And Calvin Harris, 16th chair trombone. Philip Baldado, 13th chair euphonium. Alejandro Alvarez, 15th chair euphonium. Kong Park, 7th chair tuba. Jimena Alanis, 13th chair tuba. Zoe Salinas, 2nd chair percussion. Valeria Alanis, 20th chair percussion. Aaron Salinas, 25th chair percussion. And JP Cavillo, 26th chair percussion. And to recognize our recent All-Region Jazz members, we had 1st chair trombone Antonio Reynosa, 3rd chair trombone Angel Cifuentes, and 8th chair trumpet Michael Arriaga.
Thank you, Ms. Quick. We will now move to item I, BL Gray Junior High HOSA 2021 Virtual State Leadership Conference Recognitions. Ms. Carranza and Ms. Annabelle Guerra.
Good evening, President Padilla, Dr. Vidaudi, and members of the board. Throughout the month of March, Sherryland BL Gray HOSA participated in the 2021 Virtual Texas HOSA Leadership Conference Competition. We had 20 scholars participate. All placed in the top 10 and 13 placed top three, advancing them to International Leadership Conference in Orlando, Florida, to be virtually held June 23rd to the 26th. Congratulations to Eileen Roman, first place in Math for Health Careers. Consuelo Camarillo, third place, Math for Health Careers. Ana Camarillo, 10th place, Math for Health Careers. Iman Safir, second place, Medical Terminology. Peyton McCormick, fifth place, Medical Terminology. Eliab Alvarez, ninth place, Medical Terminology. Kong Park, second place, Nutrition. Ana Teresa Ansaldúa, seventh place, Nutrition. Aaron Lee, eighth place, Nutrition. Shira Bell Bukien, first place, Life-Threatening Situations. Ava Salazar, eighth place, Life-Threatening Situations. Regina Valdez, second place, Extemporaneous Health Poster. George Flores Gomez, fifth place, Extemporaneous Health Poster. Ella Gonzalez, second place, Health Career Preparation. Ashley Aleman, first place, Health Career Explorations. Paulina Gutierrez, second place, Health Career Explorations. Sofia Carriaga, third place, Health Career Explorations. Zoe Garza, Gael Heredia, Ana Mayela Gutierrez, first place, Health Education Team. Congratulations to our Bill Gray Hosa and Mrs. Annabel Guerra. Yay. Thank you.
Thank you. Item J, Sheridan North High HOSA 2021 Virtual State Leadership Conference Recognition. Ms. Ruby Barcenas.
Good evening, President Padilla, Dr. Vidaudi, members of the board, and the school community. At Sheridan North, also in the month of March, we had HOSA members participate in the HOSA State Virtual Leadership Conference. We had six of our students participate and three advance to the HOSA International Conference that will take place also June 23rd through the 26th. We would like to commend these students for persevering through this challenging year as they demonstrated their ability to represent the North HOSA Club organization and be part of a global student-led organization recognized by the U.S. Department of Education and the Department of Health and Human Services and several federal and state agencies. I'd like to recognize our amazing sponsor, Ms. Ruby Barcenas, our parents, and of course, Central Office and School Board for all of your continued support. At this time, she's going to go ahead and read the names.
Alyssa Cedillo, fourth place, Math for Health Careers. James Kreider Gonzalez, competitor in life-threatening situations. John Kreider Gonzalez, second place, life-threatening situations. Juliet Kreider Gonzalez, competitor, Foundations of Medical Terminology. I just want to recognize the three siblings here because they are siblings at our campus. We have James and John, who are seventh grade, and we also have, they're eighth grade, and Juliet is our seventh grade, who is also our cheerleader. Mm-hmm. Mayani Rodriguez, third place in medical terminology or medical reading. Daniela Zapata, competitor in Foundations of Medical Terminology. I also wanted to recognize these students for giving the dedication, the time virtually, and also for those who are also multitasking in different areas as well. I'm very proud of them, and I want to go ahead and commend the parents as well for supporting us, okay? Thank you.
Thank you.
I'd like to add one thing that has been really awesome. Ms. Carranza, myself, and all of our staff, it's just so awesome to see how they call each other all the time through this virtual platform. Doesn't matter the subject, it doesn't matter the organization. So I want to give a huge shout out, and I know that happens district-wide. So transitioning to this and the support district-wide is just fantastic. Thank you all.
handling life-threatening situations in junior high? Wow, I'm impressed, man. Congratulations on winning that. That is incredible.
We will now move to item K, Sherland High School Athletic Recognitions. Presenter, Coach Krell.
Hello, and thank you, members of the board, Dr. V, and everyone in attendance. We'll be recognizing several sports accomplishments, and with me is Assistant Athletic Coordinator Raul Castillo, who will be starting us off.
Good evening, President Padilla, Dr. Vidaudi, and members of the board and everybody present. We're gonna start off with our boys soccer team. And our boys soccer team in 31-5A finished district runner-up, bi-district champions, area champions, regional quarterfinalists, and finished with a record of 16-6-1, and our district record of 10-4. Our boys soccer team consists of Marte de Alejandro, Fernando Ponce, Hugo Guerra, Jose Lastra, Angel Tellez, Mauricio Góngora, Marcelo Rodriguez, Ricardo Flores, Carlos López, Cesar Gutierrez, Gael Cantú, Alan Guerrero, William Jimenez, Alejandro Espinosa, Gabriel Guajardo, Felipe Andrade, Axel Rocha, Luis Tellez, Elul Villarreal, Juan Urencio, Jose Sanchez, Juan Treviño, Alex Jarvis, Juarez, Luis Chavez, Ruben Ramirez, and our coaching staff here, of course, is Coach Rev Hernandez, George Guerra, Gilberto Alaniz, and Felipe Torres. Also like to recognize here that Alex Rocha did receive an academic All-State by the Texas Association of Soccer Coaches. Our girls soccer team also did tremendous here. The girls soccer team ended up 31-5A runner-up, district by district champions, area finalists, an overall record of 24-1-1, and a district record of 12-1-1. The girls soccer team consists of Yarisbeth Zarate, Andrea Lopez, Clarissa Gonzalez, Madison Gonzalez, Irome Marquez, Aaron Requenes, Carissa Flores, Morelia Moreno, Blanca Davila, Angelina Montemayor, Xochitl Anguma, Allison Canovo, Kayla Cepeda, Paola De Alejandro, Monet Lozano, Alyssa Teniente, America Hernandez, Lily Bez Arate, Chloe Rivera, Yolibez Alvarez, Giselle Barragán, and Ana Cecilia Peña. The girls soccer team is coached by Mario Rivera, Jesus Cardenas, Alyssa Garcia, and Alexandria Serna. The girls soccer team, of course, not only did they do well, but we went ahead and collected a couple academic All-States and some district hardware here. Starting on my left here, I have Xochitl Anguma, most valuable player of District 31-5A, but academic All-State also in Tasco and the Texas High School Coaching Association. We have Monet Lozano, who also received a Tasco academic All-State, and the utility player of the year for District 31-5A is Chloe Rivera, and who also received a Tasco academic All-State. Now, both boys and girls soccer team did tremendous, and I know it was tough on everybody, but these boys and girls, I mean, they stepped up, and I mean, they did what they could. And if you were there at one of their games, you know that you saw a great performance. So congratulations to both boys and girls soccer.
Moving on to our wrestling team. We did very well this year with our wrestling. Our female athletes, we had Andrea Rubio, She was district silver medalist, regional bronze medalist, and state qualifier. Viviana Ayala, district silver medalist, and she finished fifth at regionals. Yarizbeth Zarate, district silver medalist, and fifth at regionals. Our girls finished third at the district, and our boys wrestling team, we had Paulo Miranda, district champion, regional champion, and this past weekend finished fifth at state. Albert Mendoza, district champion, and finished fifth at regionals. Jesus Cruz, district bronze medalist and regional qualifier. Federico Rodriguez, silver medalist, fifth at regionals. Noel Torres, district champion, third at regionals, state qualifier. Marcelo Navarro, district champion, fifth at regionals. Moses Rodriguez, district champion, regional silver medalist, and state qualifier. Our coaches is Sam Mangum, James Pembroke, and Angela Stingley. And on another note, our boys wrestling team finished district champions as a team, and that is the first time we've done that in school history. Moving on, we have girls tennis, boys and girls tennis. We have Eduardo Rage and Marcela Garcia, third place boys doubles, regional alternates. Jacqueline Ray, girls single, regional alternate. Monica and Mariela Castaneros, second place, girls double. Regional qualifier, the regional tennis tournament is happening right now. Olivia Source and Andrea Fernandez, district champions. Girls doubles, 31-5A regional qualifiers. The coaches are Mike Salinas and Coach Rosero Palacios. Moving on to golf. Our girls golf team placed sixth at regionals. We have Carolina Tirado, Ariana Vela, Valentina Barron, Brianna Vela, Jimena Paz, Ivana Silva. All these young ladies are sophomores and finishing sixth at regionals. We're excited to have them back for the next 2 years. They're coached by Ashley Garza and Jordan Miners. Our girls track team. At the area meet, Daniel Salinas placed first in the mile and the 2 mile and is a regional qualifier. Mariela Moreno placed third in the triple jump and is a regional qualifier. Sydney Bravo placed fourth in the 800 and is a regional qualifier. On Daniela was, we had regionals this past weekend. Daniela, I believe, finished fourth in the 2 mile, and she was about a second away from our school record. She did very well. All the girls competed very well up there. Moving on, at the area meet, Daniela placed first. De La Vega placed third. And Sydney Bravo placed fourth in the mile run, all regional qualifiers. Our coaching staff consists of Melissa Durth, Mario Garcia, Tony Flores, Marcus Perez, and Teresa Ortiz. Our girls did a great job up in regionals. It was a very long day on Friday. We had a lot of thunderstorms. They had a lot of delays and stuff like that, but they competed very well up at regionals. I'm very proud of our girls track team. Moving on to our boys track team. Lisandro Lopez is a regional qualifier in the 300 hurdles. At the district, he did 110 hurdles in fourth place, 300 hurdles in fourth place. And at the area meet, he finished the 300 hurdles in second place. Javier Ayala was a district runner-up. At the area meet, the shot put, he placed fourth. And at the regional meet, he also placed fourth with a throw of 48 feet, 5 inches. Daryl Perkins is our district champion in the triple jump. And at the area meet, he finished fifth place. Our boys track team also, we had Eric Gonzalez, Marcos Esparza, Gabriel Garza, and Pepe Terrina in the 4x2 finished fourth. And at the area meet, they finished sixth. The 4x4 consists of Luis Viriel, Lisandro Lopez, Fabian Garza, Fernando Viriel. They were district runners up. They also finished second place at the area meet. And they just missed the finals in the 4x4 at the regional meet. Diego Heredia at the district meet, he finished second in the 800. He finished fourth in the 2 mile, and he finished second in the mile. At the area meet, the 2 mile, he finished third. At the area meet, in the mile, he finished second. This young man, this last weekend, ran the 2 mile and improved his time by 22 seconds. He broke a school record. He finished third at the regional meet and is also a state qualifier. He did an outstanding job this past weekend. And our track coaches, our head track coach is Darío Sainz. Also, we have Coach Ryan Soule, Tino Hong, Danny Moran, and RC Del Fuente. Congratulations to all of our boys track athletes. You did an outstanding job. All of our young athletes that have got recognized tonight, extremely hardworking. We're very proud of them. Thank you for giving us time to recognize them, and thank you for all that you do.
Thank you, Coach Grout. We'll move to L, Sherrilyn Pioneer High School, Business Professionals of America, chapter recognition of state and national qualifiers at the Texas BPA Regional and State Leadership Conferences. Ms. Maldonado.
Hello, good evening, President Padilla, Dr. Vidaudi, and members of the board. On behalf of myself and Mrs. Campbell, we would like to announce the recognitions for the Sherrilyn Pioneer BPA Regional and State Leadership Conference. Ms. Campbell, if you'd like to begin.
Good evening. I will be announcing the BPA Regional Leadership Conference members that have moved on to the following stage. So on January 7th and 8th, the Sherrilyn Pioneer High School Business Professionals of America chapter participated in the Area 2 Region 4 Texas BPA Regional Leadership Conference held virtually. We had 22 students participate and 20 advanced to the Texas BPA State Leadership Conference. The following are the students that moved on. Our first student is Benjamin Lugo. He received third place in Fundamental Suffolk County, and he was a state qualifier. Following is Chris Villarreal, first place in Advanced Accounting. Tristan DeAnda, Payroll Accounting, first place. John LaGrange, Banking and Finance, sixth place, state alternate. Sarah LaGrange, Personal Finance, Financial Management, second place. Diego Palos Rodriguez, Economic Research Individual, first place. Angelo Bazan, Basic Office Systems and Procedures, sixth place, state alternate. Arnold Hernandez, Fundamental Spreadsheet Applications, third place. John Lewis Snyman, Legal Office Procedures, sixth place, state alternate. Diego Zambrano, Business Law and Ethics, first place. Brian Lee, Python programming, second place. Derek Lee, fundamentals of web design, first place. Tyler Moss, graphic design promotion, sixth place, state alternate. Isaac Rivera, digital media production, first place. Ashley Mejia, interview skills, fifth place, state alternate. Sophia Silva, advanced interview skills, first place. Mia Ramirez, extemporaneous speech, second place. Mariela Elizondo, ethics and professionalism, first place. Mia Rios, prepared speech, eighth place, state alternate. And Ava Schmidt, presentation management individual, first place. These were our individual students that had that competed and advanced and following our team event placements. Our first team was the broadcast news production, put together by Ava Schmidt, Tyler Moss, Mia Ramirez, and Benjamin Gomez, obtaining first place. Our next team was presentation management team with Sean Paslack, Brian Lee, Benjamin Lugo, Diego Rodriguez, and they obtained first place. Economic research team with Diego Zambrano, Mariela Elizondo, and Isaac Rivera, first place. Our financial analyst team with John LaGrange, Sarah LaGrange, Sophia Silva, and Derek Lee, obtaining first place. And our small business management team, Tristan DeAnda, Chris Villarreal, John Lewis Nyman, Angel Vassan, second place. And global marketing team with Mia Rios and Ashley Mejia, third place.
Now on to our Texas BPA State Leadership Conference that was held March 3rd through the 6th. Derek Lee, Fundamentals of Web Design, second place, national qualifier. Tristan DeAnda, Payroll Accounting, eighth place, national alternate. Tyler Moss, Graphic Design Promotion, ninth place, national alternate. Isaac Rivera, Digital Media Production, sixth place, national alternate. Our broadcast news production team, Ava Schmidt, Mia Ramirez, Tyler Moss, and Benjamin Gomez, seventh place, national alternate. Sophia Silva, newly elected 2021-2022 Texas BPA State President. Congratulations and thank you to all of our amazing Sherland Pioneer Business Professionals of America chapter. Thank you.
Congratulations and thank you. Item M, Sherland Pioneer High School UIL Academic Regional and Texas Math and Science Coaches Association recognition. Mr. Roel Cavazos.
Thank you, Mr. Padilla. Good evening, distinguished board members, Dr. Vidaudi, and members of our community. On behalf of the Sherland Pioneer UIL academic students, as well as coaches, I'm very proud to present. Is that 2020 champions, people? I'm waiting for the applause, but I can't hear it. So we have the district championship for UIL academics, as well as the three-peat regional champions, and our TMSCA state champions will be presenting to you all this evening. There's a beautiful picture of our entire district team. Like we said earlier, this is the UIL Academic Championship team from Sherland Pioneer. Go Diamondbacks! Next slide, please. I'm sorry, I lost connection there for a second. If you could go back, we skipped that first, the accounting.
Go ahead, sir. There may be a delay of signal there or a lack of signal.
All right, there we go. Yes, sir. So we have Arnold Hernandez in accounting as a sixth place state alternate, coached by Mrs. Laura Maldonado. We have Max Ramirez, calculator applications, first place regional champ, state qualifier, both individual and team. We have Brian Lee, calculator applications, third place regions, state qualifier, individual and team. We have Derek Lee, calculator applications, fourth place state qualifier, individual and team. And then we have a first place regional champions, UIL 5A. And then we have also first place 5A team TMSEA state champions for calculator applications. Pictured, we have Mrs. Juana Salas, coach, Carlos Zavala, Derek Lee, Max Ramirez, and Brian Lee. In addition, we have Amber LaBeouf, computer applications, first place state qualifier, regional champion, and she is coached by In addition, we have Sebastian Hinojosa, also in computer applications, fourth place at regionals, and he is a state alternate, and he is also coached by Mrs. Monica Campbell. Moving on to current issues and events, we have Gentry Cornelius, fourth place state alternate as an individual, but first place team. So here we have our first place current issues and events, first place regional team champions, and first place state. And we have Diego Palos Rodriguez, Gentry Cornelius. They're coached by Mr. Chris Carrizales. In addition, we have Mariana Sanchez and Jasmine Regunan. We have next Alyssa Guerra from our journalism team. She advanced in copy edit. She's a second place regional champion, and she is a state qualifier, and she is coached by Mrs. Sheena Ondoy. Also from journalism, but in feature, we have Emmanuel Ondoy, third place regional champion, state qualifier, and coached by his sister, Mrs. Sheena Ondoy. Moving on, we have Brian Lee yet again giving us the thumbs up in mathematics, first place state qualifier, as well as first place regional, and he's moving on as an individual as well as on team. Next, we have Derek Lee, also in mathematics, second place regional champion, state qualifier, both individual and team. We have Max Ramirez, also in mathematics, third place regional champion, state qualifier, and individual, both individual and team, excuse me. And this is our mathematics team. This is first place regional champions, moving on as state qualifiers. In addition to that, they are also our third place 5A team TMSEA state champions. And pictured are Carlos Zavala, Jordan Salinas. They are coached by Mr. Jose Jaramillo. And we have Derek Lee, Brian Lee, and Max Ramirez. Moving on to number sense, we have Derek Lee, first place regional champion state qualifier, both individual and team. And that's a typo there, sorry about that, but still in number sense, we have Jordan Salinas. He's a fourth place state qualifier in number sense, both individual and team. And with number sense, we basically swept all of the math events at regionals, picking up another first place regional champions, first place 5A TMSCA state champions, and pictured are Carlos Zavala, Jordan Salinas. They are coached by Mr. Anthony Villarreal. We also have Derek Lee, Brian Lee, and Max Ramirez pictured as well. And finally, we have Max Ramirez yet again, first place regional champion and state qualifier for science. He also picked up a UIL top physics. And then for TMSEA, he was a first place TMSEA 5A state champion. And our science team is coached by Mrs. Nancy Ochoa Garza, Mr. Carlos Solis, and Mr. Manolo Calata. That concludes our presentation. On behalf of my wife, Rocio, and I, who are the UIL coordinators, as well as our principal, Belinda Garcia, we want to thank our community members, we want to thank our board members, and most importantly, we want to thank all of our parents who allow us the opportunity to work with such amazing and driven young adults. It makes us proud to know that they will be our future leaders. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. We'll move to item N, Sherland Pioneer High School Athletic Recognition, presenter Coach Eddie Galindo.
I don't have him online, sir.
No. Yeah, we can come back to it if we need to. All right. We'll now move to item six, public comments. Are there any public comments?
No.
No public comments. Item seven, informational items. 7A, discussion of COVID-19 related items. Presenter Dr. Vidaudi.
Yes, Mr. President, members of the board, we have two items for you today. Again, the update on attendance, and also Mr. Dodery will talk to you a little bit about the vaccination clinic that we had this weekend. So Ms. Montalvo.
Good evening, President Padilla, members of the board, Dr. Vidaudi. We're excited to announce that more and more we are encouraging as much as possible to have our students join us on campus for instruction. And we are proud to announce that we have finally made it over the 20% mark in our school, 20% of our total enrollment in our schools. David, if you'll scroll up just a little bit. Sorry. You can see our elementaries once again, our highest rate of on-person attendance is at Shimatsu Elementary with 38.6%. We're very, very proud to hit the milestone of 21.2% of our students in our schools, and we look forward to more of them joining us throughout the end of the year. Finished very strong.
Yes, I will be sending a letter out to the community today. The parents should get that by tomorrow, inviting our students back to school. So we're excited about that, and hopefully we'll see these numbers grow.
Dr. Vidaudi, and I ask this just generally, but one of the most common questions I get asked is the state going to require us to open school in fall? And have you heard anything?
Right. We're keeping a close ear to that through the business office, through my office as well. At this point, we don't know definitely. Now, we are hearing things back and forth about maybe a hybrid method, but right now, as of right
still
now,
uncertain.
There's nothing definite.
I want to know. Thank you.
We are hoping to be 100% in person, is what our hope would be.
Anything else for the COVID?
Yes, okay. Just a real quick.
Mr. Padilla, Dr. Vidaudi, board members. So I'm pleased to announce that this past Saturday morning, we had a COVID vaccine clinic that was a closed pod for our students. We had approximately 100 students get vaccinated. And on top of that, we had about 33 parents and teachers who still needed a vaccine come through and get vaccinated this past Saturday. So we're excited that we were able to reach out into our community and get them vaccinated. We're here from about 8 to 11. Our second dose vaccine clinic will be on the 15th of May. It was a Pfizer vaccine, so that's how we were able to vaccinate our 16 and 17-year-olds. So we're excited about that. We also got in a few of our 18-year-olds, too, that hadn't been able to get vaccinated. So we're happy that we were able to present this service to our community. Do you have any questions? Thank you.
Thank you, Mark. We will now move to item B, announcement of board member continuing education credit hours. We'll be reading that. These are just the continuing education report that the board members need to fulfill each year. So I'll read out the names and the total hours and whether they met the requirements or not. Keith Badia, 27.75 hours exceeds requirement. Dr. Noy Oliveira, 35.50 exceeds requirement. Jose Pepe Garcia, 21 hours exceeds requirement. Hector Rivera, 22 hours exceeds requirements. Ricky Longoria, 19.75 exceeds requirements. Melissa Smith, 11.75 exceeds requirements. And Alejandro Rodriguez, 14.00 hours exceeds requirements. That's for the record. Thank you. Eddie? Okay. Okay, Coach Galindo, are you there?
Yes, sir.
All right, we'll now move forward with the Sherland Pioneer High School athletic recognitions. Go ahead when you're ready.
Get the PowerPoint up.
1 second, sir.
Okay. We're good?
Yes, sir.
Everybody hear me good? Okay, good evening. Thank you everybody for having us here and recognizing our student athletes at Pioneer High School. Tremendous job. Once again, our student athletes are doing a remarkable job representing Pioneer, representing Sherrilland ISD and our community. Super, super proud of their accomplishments and everything they're doing representing our school and community. Girls regional qualifiers, Emily Trevino, district champion, Alejandra Briere, district runner-up, Camila Flores, district champion in wrestling. Boys regional qualifiers, Kenny Briere is a district champion, Austin Sines is a district runner-up, Noah Ramos, district runner-up, and Joel Garza. Girls state qualifiers, Emily Trevino was a regional champion, Alejandra Briere is a regional runner-up. And a boys state qualifier was Kenny Briere. Our state qualifiers in the boys 132-pound division was Kenny Briere, the girls 119-pound division, Emily Trevino, and the girls 110-pound division was Alejandra Briere. Our Pioneer boys track and field area and regional qualifiers, senior was Cesar Ramirez, an area in the 1600 and 3200-meter run, and also qualify for regionals in the 1600-meter run. He was ninth in the 1600-meter run and regionals. A junior, Gabriel Sanchez, in the pole vault, our area and regional qualifier. He tied for ninth at regionals. A sophomore, Dylan Salinas, area in the 300-meter hurdles. Junior, Rosendo Melendez, district champion in the pole vault and an area qualifier. Sophomore Evan Thompson, district champion in the shot put and discus, area and regional qualifier in both. He was 10th in the shot put and 5th in discus at regionals, San Antonio. We have a senior, Sean Poslak, in the pole vault, area qualifier. Freshman Sebastian Coronado in the high jump. freshman Leo Espinosa, 110 meter hurdles, high hurdles, and area and regional qualifier, and he placed 10th at regionals in San Antonio. Great job at our track and field. Remarkable job, and just super proud of these guys. Our regional area regional qualifiers, junior Jason Cavazos in the 400 meter dash at area and regionals. Sophomore Ryan Cervantes in the 800 meter run at area and regional qualifier. He placed second in the 800 at regionals, seventh. Senior Gabriel Kelly, junior Jason Cavazos, junior Luis Garcia, sophomore Ryan Cervantes in the 4x4 meter relay at area and regionals, and they were 10th place at regionals. Just want to give a little shout out to our coaches and track staff at Pioneer, Coach De La Fuente, our head track coach, Coach Vela, his first assistant, Coach Oviedo, the 800 run, Mr. Coach Peña in the discus, Coach Lee, Jordan Lee, in the 400 and mile relay, Anthony Berrial in the pole vault, Alexis Peña and in the 1632 distance runs, and Bobby O in the shot put. No. Okay, our girls track and field area and regional qualifiers. Sophomore Sophie Ponce de Leon in the 800 and 400 meter relays. In the high jump, junior Brianna de los Reyes. Senior Denise San Miguel in the 800 and 400 meter relays. And junior regional qualifier Caitlin Salazar in the 800, 400 meter relays and the 100 meter dash. Sophomore Valentina Morales in the 800 meter relay. Senior Frida Madrigal in the 400 meter relay. Sophomore Sable Glick in the pole vault. And Daisy Monet, she's a new shot. She's got the Valley record, area record holder, regional qualifier, district and area champion in the shot and distance. She's also our regional champ in the discus and our regional runner-up in the shot puts, and she's headed to state in both of those events. So good job to our students there, student athletes. Our coaching staff doing a remarkable job with them, guiding them and inspiring them. It's Coach Garza, our head track and field coach, Coach Peña, Coach Olvera, Coach Wagner, and Coach Berriat. Our Pioneer Golf, back on the course, 2021, district champs, Rebecca Salinas, Jocelyn Lopez, Kaylee Cruz, Mariela Elizondo, and Gabriela Astorga, our district champs for this year's golf. Individually, Kaylee Cruz is our district champion team, district champion individual medalist, regional qualifier, district 31-5A MVP, and a state qualifier. Jocelyn Lopez is a district champion team, district medalist runner-up, a regional qualifier, and our first team all-district. Our 31-5A runner-up team regional qualifiers, Chris Berrial, Ryan Montoya, Gabriel Guerrero, Ryan Bagwell, and Lucas Escamilla. Gabriel Guerrero is a 31-5A medalist runner-up and a regional qualifier. Great job by our golf team, and we're going to support Kaylee on her way to hopefully successfully do well. I know she'll do well up there in state. Okay, our individual tennis, they're up there competing as we speak. Coaches Rick Rivera and Jennifer Kaltenbach. regional qualifiers are Angel Martinez and Alyssa Cantu. They placed second in mixed doubles at the 31-5A district tournament. Angel Martinez will be making his first appearance to the tennis regional meet in San Antonio. Alyssa Cantu will be making her second appearance at the regional tournament. Both players placed individually at every tournament this year with the exception of one. Great job there. Individual accomplishments, Angel Martinez is a senior. He's this year's 2021 boys MVP. He's a three-year letterman. He's part of the 2018-19 boys district championship team. He's one of the top three players on the team, and he helped our team to the tennis playoffs last 3 years. Alyssa is also a senior. She's this year's 2021 girls MVP, a two-time MVP 2018-19. She's a four-year letterman, a two-time regional qualifier, and she helped lead her team to the tennis playoffs the last 4 years. Girls singles regional qualifier. We placed at the Harlingen Varsity Gold, second place, Memorial Gold Varsity, third place, with Sarah LaGrange, a freshman, and district second place. Okay, great job by our tennis, our girls, and our qualifiers that are competing up there in San Antonio. We're really rooting for them, supporting them. They do a remarkable job. All of our sports, our spring sports are up to date. We got our baseball team in the playoffs. Our softball is also in the playoffs. So we're expecting some great things from them and really representing us, Pioneer, the Sherrilyn ISD, and our community, like they always do, with class and integrity, and we're just really excited. Thanks for having me on.
Okay, thank you, Coach. Let's see, we were on eight, right? All right, we will now go back to item eight. The consent agenda to include A, March 2021 month-end bills, B, March 2021 tax collection report, C, March 2021 financial reports, D, third quarter investment report for March 31st, 2021, E, budget amendments, 1, child nutrition fund, 2, debt service fund, and F, previous meeting minutes, 1, regular board meeting, March 29th, 2021. Do I have a motion to approve?
So moved.
Got a motion by Dr. Noy Oliveira.
Second.
Second by Ricky Longoria. Any further discussion? All those in favor signal by saying aye.
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 All opposed, same sign. Motion carries 6-0. Item 9, business. A, discussion and consideration to approve to submit waiver to TAEA for asynchronous days during winter storm. Presenter Dr. Vidaudi and Mr. Rosinski.
Yes, Mr. Rosinski.
Hello, Devont.
Good evening, President Padilla, members of the board. Dr. Vidaudi and I come to you tonight to request permission to file a waiver with TEA for the asynchronous days that we use during Winter Storm Uri. TEA sent out guidance during that. I've included that in your packet as well as our supporting documentation. Basically, they gave us permission to go asynchronous for those days. We just have to submit the waiver so we get the minutes back.
So moved.
Second.
Got a motion by Dr. Oliveira and a second by Ricky Longoria. Any further discussion?
Just noted that we did discuss this in our workshop in much more detail, as well as some of the other items that are to follow. So thank you.
Yes.
Okay. Motion by Dr. No and a second by Ricky Longoria. Any further discussion? All those in favor signal by saying aye.
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 All opposed, same sign. Motion carries 6-0. B, discussion and consideration to approve to purchase technology equipment for career and technical education students from co-op approved vendors, Ms. Montalvo and Ms. Nava.
Yes, good evening once again. This was an item that was discussed in detail during our board workshop on Monday. And what we are asking the board for approval is to purchase 31 lab computers for the SHS Ag department, and then also to increase our number of laptops from 20 to 36 at both of our junior highs, and to replace the initial 20 at Beale Gray for 52 engineering laptops that will be used with our project lead the way. pathway. And the grand total for this would be $167,690.47, and we're recommending going with Dell as them being the low bidder.
Another item we discussed in length at the workshop.
So moved.
Got a motion by Dr. Noe Oliveira.
Second.
Second by Mr. Alejandro Rodriguez. Any further discussion? All those in favor signal by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries 6-0. C, discussion and consideration to approve employee benefits plan. Presenter, Mr. Ortega and Mr. Doherty.
Sir, thank you, President Padilla, Dr. Vidaldi, members of the board. This is an item that was presented at the insurance committee and at the board workshop. Administration is recommending approving the proposed changes to the employee benefit plan as presented with an effective date of July 1st, 2021. Mr. Doherty and Mr. Garza are available if there's any additional questions. Thank you.
This is an item that we discussed in depth also at the workshop. I don't know if anybody has any questions or.
Motion to approve.
Got a motion by Ricky Longoria.
Second.
Second by Alejandro Rodriguez. Any further discussion? All those in favor signal by saying aye.
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 All opposed, same sign. Motion carries 6-0. Item D, discussion and consideration to approve the financial advisor contract for 2021 through 2023. Presenter, Mr. Ortega.
Yes, sir. Once again, this is an item that was presented at the board workshop. Attaches a renewal agreement for financial advisory services from Estrada, Hinojosa & Company. The agreement is for 2 years. There are no changes to the fee rates. There is no cost at this time. Fees will only be incurred if services are utilized. And I do believe we have Dr. De Los Santos in the audience.
Yes, so moved.
And motion by Dr. Noe Oliveira.
Second.
Second by Ricky Longoria. Any further discussion? All those in favor signal by saying aye.
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 All those opposed, same sign. Motion carries 6-0. Item E, discussion and consideration to approve the chiller replacement at the Sheridan High School Building 400 using co-op approved vendors. Mr. Ortega and Mr. Doherty.
Yes, sir. This item was briefly discussed at the board workshop. The district has since received 3 bids from cooperative approved vendors. Mr. Doherty has a little bit more information.
So brought up at the board workshop during the construction update, we have been having issues with the chiller. We do have it working right now, but it is in desperate need of a change out. So we did go out for bids, pricing from our 3 cooperative vendors. And we are recommending Johnson Controls in the amount of $138,350.56. If there's any questions, I do have our engineer.
The chiller unit is just, I mean, we're not just replacing the controls, we're replacing the total unit for the 400 building?
Yes, sir. It's that whole outside unit. It's kind of like if at your home you have your condensing unit outside.
Yeah.
Same thing, same concept, just a lot bigger.
Yeah.
So it's the outside unit that needs to be that we're requesting to have it changed out.
The reason I'm asking is that when we did talk about it in the workshop, I was expecting the cost to be substantially more than what it was being presented today, and so that's why conceptually I wanted to make sure I was thinking the right thing.
We were very pleasantly surprised with the pricing we've got, Mr. Longoria, because we were looking at a higher cost, but when we went out and the engineers. I have Mr. Cesar Gonzalez with Ethos Engineering, and when they went out and helped us procure it, they were able to get us favorable pricing.
We appreciate your work on that. Yeah. It's really good. Thank you.
Yeah, so, well, that's fine. Again, I just want to make sure we were getting what.
Yes, sir.
Because I was thinking something else.
Yeah, yes, me too.
Yeah.
It usually is.
Yeah, no, it's usually, I mean, we're talking significant. I mean,
yeah.
Not saying that's not significant, but
right.
In the grand scheme of things.
Thank you again.
And that's all I had. Thank you.
And if I may add, we did complete our capital improvement projects for this year, and we had some savings there, so this will not require any sort of budget amendment.
Even better.
We got it all within budget.
I misstole your thunder, Mark.
Good job, guys. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
So, motion?
Yes, so moved.
Motion by Dr. Noe Oliveira.
Second.
Second by Ricky Longoria. Any further discussion? All those in favor signal by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries 6-0. F, discussion of RFP 2021-15, Bank Depository. Presenter, Ms. Ortega.
Yes, sir. Thank you. This is also an item that was presented at the board workshop. I know there was some confusion as far as the explanation of costs and then the how to calculate the net annual interest earned. We apologize for that, so hopefully we'll go through it and answer any questions if there are any. So we did go out for bank depository bid. We had 13 banks within the district boundaries that received the package. The bid also appeared in the Monitor newspaper on February 22nd and March 1st. Six banks responded to the district's request for proposal. So our preliminary evaluation was to make sure that all proposals were reviewed and to make sure all documentation was submitted. For example, the cashier check, addendums, conflict of interest questionnaire, debarment certification, non-conclusion statement. And so just happy to say that all six banks did submit all required documentation. Additional evaluation included us looking at the cost of services, interest rates offered, additional services offered, funds availability schedule, automated services, the ability of the bank to provide the necessary services, collateralization policy, and fraud prevention and notification policy. Again, all six banks did meet or did have everything we were looking for. So our bid evaluation, we concentrated on three things: the service fees, interest rate, and if the bank offered an earnings credit rate. The third thing we looked at was online banking capabilities. Again, when it comes to item number three, all six banks could provide the services that the district is required. So we concentrated on the first two things, the service fees, interest rate, and the earnings credit rate, the things that we can measure. As an example of the calculations, we did provide this example here. So for instance, Valley Bank calculation example. So in this case, the district monthly average balance in the bank was $30 million. The bank proposed an interest rate of 0.18, and in this case, this bank provided an earning credit rate of 0.23%. And for this particular example, they said that the fees would be $1,800 for the services for the month. So the first thing we did was we calculated the interest, the daily interest, and the daily ECR rate. Real simple calculation, you take the interest rate and the earning credit rate percentage, and you divide it by 365 days, and you would get your daily interest rate and your daily ECR rate. So in this case, this bank does provide earnings credit rate, and basically what that does, it allows the district to be able to offset the service fees, which in this case was $1,800. So in order to do that, we'd have to calculate how much of a balance is required in order to offset those costs. So in this example here, we determined that $10 million was the requirement in order for us to offset those costs. And again, you have the calculation of how we determined that. So after that, what we did was we wanted to calculate how much interest would the district earn with this example. So what we did, again, we took the balance on the account, $30 million, and then you subtract the $10 million, which is what was required to offset the expenses. And so the difference, the $20 million, is what the district would earn interest on. You multiply that out, there's a formula. And again, in this case, the district would have earned $2,958 in interest. So in order to maintain confidentiality and because we are still in the evaluation process, we did provide the actual bank comparison that we're looking at. This is this handout that we passed out. So the first box here, it explains the interest rate that the banks are providing. And for instance, the ECR, there are four banks that are offering the ECR rate. The second little box there, we calculated what that balance requirement would be in order to offset the fees that the bank said that we would incur. What we did was we provided them the month of January 2021. So they analyzed that and they indicated to us, based on that month, the average monthly costs. So in looking at the middle square, we were able to determine that we needed the average balance for the ECR in order to offset the cost. So for the first four, if you look at the annual cost, there is no cost because the ECR rate would have offset that. When you're looking at the last square, again, we were able to determine what the interest rate would be that the district would earn after offsetting the cost. And again, we annualized that so you could see there potentially how much the district would have earned in interest once those fees were offset. So I don't know if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer them. So I guess at this time, what we're asking is for the May board workshop, do we bring all six banks in to do a presentation, or do we continue with our evaluation and recommend someone for the May board meeting?
Well, I think that question was asked the last meeting. The consensus was that we were going to bring them all. So I don't understand what may have changed.
Unless anybody has any.
I mean, if it's.
Questions.
Well, I just I guess for clarification, we wanted to make sure, based on the questions that were asked the last time, if y'all still want the six presentations, we'll do that. Because I did hear, you know, a couple of maybe wanting the top three or the top four banks to present. But if we want all six, then not a problem. We'll have that ready for the board workshop.
That's fine.
Is that what we want?
Good.
I mean, I don't see why all six if we can only choose, if we choose a top three and why even consider the rest if they're not meeting what the other three can offer?
Well, because I would want to hear the all six to see if there's something we're missing in the evaluation process. I mean, when you think about it, even if you look at our current depository, maybe not, I'm trying to be careful because I know.
Right.
Maybe just a confidentiality, but we haven't changed depositories, certainly in any of the times that I've been here, 13 years. And it seemed to me that if we're going to change a depository, we're also implied a long-term relationship with them. And if we're talking time, we're just asking, hey, would you be willing to invest another 30, 40 minutes of our time to hear what everybody has to say, knowing that the outcome is going to impact, you know, years going forward. So I do think it's a good use of time. Anyway, that's my opinion.
Okay, well, we can be ready if that's what.
Okay. So that's just discussion, right?
Mm-hmm. That was just discussion.
Okay. Thanks, Simon. We will now move to item 10, closed meeting, 10A. Do I have a motion to go into closed meeting?
So moved.
Second.
Got a motion by Dr. Noe Oliveira and a second by Ricky Longoria. Any further discussion? All those in favor signal by saying aye.
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 Aye. Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries 6-0. Items to be discussed in closed meeting. A, personnel matters, Texas Government Code 551.074. 1, consideration of possible action on personnel matters, resignations, and employment of personnel. A, consider approval of mid-year contract resignations. B, consider approval of employment of personnel. 2, consider superintendent's recommendations regarding employment and contract status for classroom teachers and other non-administrative professional personnel. A, renewal of probationary contracts. B, renewal of employment of term contract employees. C, renewal or employment of non-certified contract employees. B, deliberation regarding the appointment, employment evaluation, reassignment, duty, discipline, or dismissal or proposed termination of a district employee or public officer or employee pursuant to Texas Government Code 551.074. C, discussion of employee, public officer, and or board member. D, student discipline. E, deliberation regarding real property, Texas Government Code 551.072. 1, discussion and possible action to accept offer from condemning authority and authorize board president to execute all closing documents necessary to effectuate sale of real property known as parcel 131, which is more particularly described as a 1,109 square foot .0.0255 of 1 acre, parcel of land out of that tract described as 1.06 of 1 acre conveyed to Sherryland Independent School District by warranty deed dated September 11th, 1996, as recorded in document number 1996-565108 official records, Hidalgo County, Texas, being within the limits of the map of the John H. Sherry subdivision, Lot 413, as recorded in Volume 1, page 17, map records, Hidalgo County, Texas. F, consultation with attorney regarding A, pending or contemplated litigation, B, a settlement offer, or C, a matter in which the duty of the attorney to the Sheridan Independent School District under the Texas Disciplinary Rules of Professional Conduct of the State Bar of Texas clearly conflicts with Chapter 551 of the Texas Government Code, Texas Government Code 551.071. It is now 7:46, and we will go back to closed session. for hanging around. I see you, Officer Joe.
I know,
Jake's over here.
Is Jake there?
Where's Jake?
Got bad news, Jake.
That's Jake.
8:50, we're back from closed meeting. 11A, discussion and possible action on closed meeting items.
I move to approve the mid-year contract resignations as recommended. I move to approve the renewal employment of probationary contract employees as recommended by the administration in closed session. I move to approve the renewal employment of term contract employees as recommended by the administration in closed session. And I move to approve the renewal employment of non-certified professional contract employees as recommended by administration in closed session.
Do I have a motion to approve the recommendations?
There's a motion.
We've got a motion by Alejandro Rodriguez. Do I have a second? Second by Dr. Noy Oliveira. Any further discussion? All those in favor signal by saying aye.
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 All opposed, same sign. Motion carries 5-0. Melissa Smith had to
she
step out at 8:26 p.m. for the record. And is that all of them?
It is.
Okay. Mr. President, with regard to the real property, we're recommending that the board make a motion to approve an acceptance of the offer from the condemning authority and authorize the board president to execute all closing documents necessary to effectuate the sale of the real property identified as parcel 131, as stated on the agenda.
Do I have a motion, as stated by legal, by Dr. Noy Oliveira? And a second?
Second.
So
second by Alejandro Rodriguez. Any further discussion? All those in favor signal by saying aye.
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 All opposed, same sign. Motion carries 5-0. Do I have a motion to adjourn?
So move.
Second.
Dr. No. Second by Hector Rivera. Any further discussion? All those in favor signal by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries 5-0. Meeting is adjourned.
8:52 p.m.